say a quick word before we get started. First, thank you so much for coming. For those of you who don't know, this is the second time we've done the Composer on Stage concert. We did our first one last season with the guitarist Clifton Ingram, guitarist, composer, and bassist Max Dugelson. The whole idea of this is, a long time ago, it was a given that composers were also performers. And very often performers had a hand in composing. They had some experience with that. And that has kind of faded in history. But we thought it would be a nice thing to do to, first of all, try to revive the tradition a little bit. But second of all, to bring composers onto the stage. Because they may have a unique interpretive sensibility. What we plan to do with this mini-series, we're going to do one or two of these concerts every season, is have the composers put together a program that includes their own music and music of their choosing that complements it nicely, their casual concerts, and they're a lot of fun. I encourage you, on the back of your program, if you have not seen, we have one more upcoming concert this season. Just one. It's been a very long season. This is our third season. We've done a lot of music, more than we expected. And our last concert is on May 14th at 8 o'clock. It's called Kinetics. It features our own Equilibrium Ensemble. It's going to be at the Davis Square Theater in Davis Square in Somerville. I hope you can make it. It'll be a really interesting program. It should be a lot of fun. Nice video on the season. Try to put together some concerts over the summer, and we will be announcing our next season as soon as everything's finalized, so stay tuned, keep in touch. Finally, I have to say this, we operate entirely on the generous donations of our guests. If you like what you hear and you feel so inclined to donate, we'd be very appreciative. And no donation is too small or too large. So, you can speak to me about that. Final word. Does anyone not have earplugs who would like earplugs? These are trumpets, and it's a small room. Are we good? Enjoy the concert. Thank you very much.
Solo, where you just play the top line, and as a duet, where a second part is added to the top line, I thought it would be cool to add a second part to this piece in the same setting. So this is the premiere of that.
Thank you.
by Donald Erb. Dance You Monster to My Song also has a bit of an Oberlin connection for me. It was written for Brian Anthony, who was my puppet at Oberlin for 2 years. And also Donald Erb was, he started life out as a trumpet player and played a lot of jazz. Wrote a lot of trumpet music, including this piece for Ryan Anthony and also a bunch of cool trumpet pieces. And so this is in, it's going to be in 3 pretty long movements, and if you don't have earplugs, this is one of the louder things.
Earplugs?
Pass these up.
Just cut one. About this piece in the program. It was written for, I wrote it last summer for the Oregon University, the Oregon Bach Festival Composer Symposium at Oregon University. The Bach Festival has been going on for years, and it's mostly a classical series that happens every summer. But they've, over the past decade or so, I guess at this point, they've had a composer symposium as part of that, which was, it's a neat opportunity of composers that go can go as a composer and performer and be involved in improvisation groups and things. So it was a neat opportunity, and so it was fun to write a piece and also intimidating to write this piece that I was going to have to then go to learn and play. So had to keep that in mind when I was writing these really hard stuff that I tend to write.
transformation since then. And I want to thank my good friend Emily Coe here for agreeing to play it with me. The title, as you can read in your program notes, alludes to its obvious sort of jazz influences, which you'll hear in the piece. But it's not a jazz piece. It's more of, I think I don't remember exactly how I said it in program notes, but it's like viewing, it's sort of like looking at sort of like an echo of jazz, like with the riffs and stuff that happen, sort of through a more abstract aural sort of context. But that's a very fancy way to say it. Just listen.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
one knows this piece and has perfect pitch, then I apologize. So this piece, I found this piece a while back, and until very recently was always very intimidated to play it because there's a lot of notes. I like the piece. It's really cool, and it's just very. You can read the program notes there, and there. Thank you for whoever found this program notes, by the way. It's very technical, and the piece does revolve around sort of like the procedures that it talks about in the piece. But audibly, what you can take away from it is they're really sort of a meditation on a very small set of notes. So you have a few set of notes at the beginning that are sort of repeated or are sort of embellished in different ways. And then that set of notes sort of expands over the piece, but those sort of initial notes always are sort of always at the core, but the collection expands as you go. And stylistically, the piece was actually inspired by, he was very sort of transfixed by the sound of the Muslim, like, call it a prayer that happens, and sort of the embellishments that take place there. So it's a very sort of, if you know nothing about the technique, it's just I think it's a very beautiful sort of expressive piece. Hopefully I will do it justice.
Thank you. Thank you.
I
Thank you.